Hello everyone. This work has been put forward in AAAFM UCLA 2021 conference as an oral presentation on synthesis of polyvinyl alcohol chitosan nanofibers embedded with silver nanoparticles and its activity on breast cancer cells. Myself, Amreen Khan, from the Center for Research in Nanotechnology and Sciences, Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay, India. Going ahead with the presentation, first part includes the formation of silver nanoparticles, which was done through polyvinyl pyrrolidine and glucose, in which the silver nitrate solutions was drop-wise added, and further the separation of silver nanoparticles after its formation was done through centrifugation process. And later on in the second part, the polyvinyl alcohol and chitosan is used as a fiber solution in which the silver nanoparticles formed in part one was incorporated, and further electrospin with optimization of voltage and the speed. And in the fibers obtained were having particles in it, and this is the representative image. This is the scanning electron microscopic image of the fibers, confirming the morphology and formation of the fiber. The reason we opted for silver nanoparticle here is because it is present in many of the FDA approved nanomedicine, and whereas PV and chitosan turned out to be a good delivery system in which the fibers provide a high aspect ratio for controlled release of many of the medicinal product. Plus they are biocompatible and biodegradable. For the characterization, we opted first for the scanning electron microscopy to confirm the silver nanoparticle and PVA chitosan fibrous formation, wherein the spherical structure of the AGNP confirmed its morphology, and further the size also was roughly estimated to be around 60 nanometer, wherein in case of the fibers incorporated the nanoparticles showed the morphology and width to be of 2200 to 300 nanometers. The inset shows that there are the nanoparticles are present. So further, in order to confirm about the size, morphology and the structure of the nanoparticles, we carried out TEM analysis. Transmittance electron microscopic analysis was carried out, and which shows the metallic fringes confirming that the silver formed is of metallic nature, as well as the diffraction images confirm that it is of monocrystalline nature. Then further, the spectra also confirmed that these particles are of silver, and the XRD stated the a sharp peak to be of the crystalline nature. So also the dynamic light scattering index showed that the size to be nearly around 66 nanometer, and the dispersity index to be lower as 0.39. Then in order to see whether the nanoparticles were present inside the fibers, we carried out the TEM analysis of the fibers along with the, embedded with the nanoparticles. And here are the diffraction images showing that the nanoparticles which is present inside the fiber is of monodispersed nature. Further, while the area spectrum was done through the help of the EDS, so EDS analysis showed that the nanoparticles are distributed uniformly inside the fibers. Now, the absorbance of silver nanoparticles showed that the lambda max was around 420 nanometer. FTIR was carried out on the fibrous sheet, which we obtained, wherein the control was kept at PVA and chitosan, that is the plane without AG nanoparticles, and a rest of the four peaks showing that the spectra are showing those with the AGNP. Herein the saturation was obtained when the thickness of the fibers actually increased, and also the amide bonds were flattened a bit when AGNP was incorporated, showing that AG and N bond were formed. Then the further, in order to study the release pattern of AGNPs, we did the analysis in DPBS, the phosphate buffer, which is in the 5.6 and 7.4, showing that 5.6, that is the acidic pH, more release of AGNPs were observed. The estimation of AGNs one was done to ICP-AES throughout the study. Just to confirm the mechanical property, the mechanical strength of the fibers which we obtained, we have seen that the elasticity modulus, tensile strength, resilience percentage, elongation was found to be quite good with respect to the cross-linked fiber, and also when on addition of silver nanoparticles, we have seen that there is a good mechanical strength. Further, the in vitro studies was carried out to assess the biocompatibility and cytotoxicity of the nanoparticles along with the PP and chitosan fiber. So L929S fibroelastic cell line was taken to assess the biocompatibility, and with an extract of 100 mg per ml, it was seen that still 85, more than 85% viability of L929 is present. Then IC50 value was calculated with the MCF7 MDA-MB breast cancer cell line, showing that approximately 6.93 and 7.48 of the silver ions were found to be more effective as an anti-cancerous agent. Estimation was done with the help of ICP-AES, and the treatment time or the result reported is after 24 hours. Below is the morphology of the cells and the intactness after treatment at different concentrations of the PBA, chitosan, AGNPs. And the cellular uptake studies have shown that AGNPs was well taken by the cells, and rhodamine was used, was conjugated with AGNP as, and rhodamine turned out to be a fluorophore, showing the intensity as a representative image for cellular uptake of AGs. These images were taken after 24 hours of incubation, and shows on the fibroblast as well as breast cancer cell lines. The antibacterial activity was further confirmed by taking the OD readings and the optical density readings after 24 hours of fiber adhesion. And in order to detach the bacterial cells from the fiber, we even sonicated it for 10 minutes. And further analysis shows that after addition of AGNP in both E. coli and S. aureus bacterial strain, there was a decrease in the OD when taken at 600 mm. So conclusively, the high aspect ratio of the nanofibers assisted in the control of AGNP release, and showed a very good activity on the breast cancer cell lines, wherein the biocompatibility on L929 at same concentration and even at higher concentration was reported to be well established. Nevertheless, I would like to thank Professor Rohit Srivastava, my guide and mentor and support of all time, NanoBio's lab, Bioscience and Bioengineering, IIT Bombay Indian, Dr. Mayuri Gandhi, Center for Research in Nanotechnology and Sciences, IIT Bombay India, Professor Jayesh Bilari, Chemical Engineering, IIT Bombay India, for providing the facility with electrospinning, Ms. Preeti, Ms. Deepak from Chemical Engineering, Professor Anil, Head CRNTS, IIT Bombay, Ms. Vinita, Ms. Reshma, Dr. Gajendra, Dr. Aradhana, Ms. Priyanka, Mr. Amit, Mr. Ashish, Ms. Princy, and all of the CRNTS staff for helping me to achieve this work and the results. Also, a Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, has been for funding me and providing me the opportunity to carry out this work. Thank you very much.